tell him sit down. Be humble, 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 sit down.
Greetings, everyone, from San Antonio. The Spurs playing host to a Western Conference affair here at the sold-out AT&T Center. And get ready for another dose of NBA basketball on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony and Brent Berry, this is Kevin Harlan. We'll be hearing from David Aldridge on the sideline. This road trip for the Thunder kicking things off here in this one. A great start to the season for them, notching three wins to tip it off.
And what you love about rivalry games, doesn't matter where the teams are in the standings, this is about pride.
Well, as much as guys talk about it and try to downplay it, we know what's at stake here. You get into the game, and then your emotions take over.
Now let's get a pregame report from Hall of Famer David Aldridge, who spoke with Greg Popovich. David.
Well, guys, he has an admiration for what he called the intelligent, efficient offense played by today's opponent. He told me that the thing about this team is that they are so good at identifying the weak spots in an opponent, and they come at you in multiple ways depending on where those weak spots are. He said, we've got to be ready for everything. Pretty tall order. Guys?
Thanks, David. So, Brent, surprises here early in the season. A few teams outperforming expectations. What can they do to keep building on this momentum?
I think the coaching staff in these sort of instances, Kevin, maybe where you're out kicking your coverage a little bit, maybe they've got to remind their team about, you know, the small steps that we need to take. Yes, we're doing this. Don't forget about doing these things or what we're doing offensively. But make sure that the reality of what the season represents, that they understand that, so their expectations don't get them too big-headed, so you have to reel them in.
Sounds like you're talking about staying with the fundamentals.
Well, the fundamentals can always help you, Kevin. And then also just continuity, making sure that each guy understands that you've done your role, continue to do your role, and the guys behind you are ready to go in case we start slipping.
Now the opening lineup for the Oklahoma City Thunder. Westbrook and Robertson are the backcourt pair. Paul George is out there with Anthony, and it's Adams, and at the pivot spot, manning the middle. The San Antonio Spurs able to put the first points up on the board.
The awareness of Russell Westbrook to locate the open man and deliver a strike, something he's developing.
Now here's Mills. He's coming off a 13-point game against the Timberwolves in Minneapolis.
Loved his passing tonight as well. He was just cutting the defense to pieces out there.
Now here's Green. Down to five on the shot clock. Can't get it to fall, and he's missed the second after making his first. Leaps for it. Anthony, the pass to Adams. And Roberson kicks to George. Adams against Gasol. Some nice passing by Oklahoma City here. Anthony down low. That one, no good.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Always am amazed at the consistency of what Carmelo Anthony and his ability to score the basketball has done. Averaged 20 points per game, even as a rookie. And no matter the situation, he definitely can carry a team with his scoring.
For Oklahoma City, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. And the shot goes in. Roberson's got his first 2 points of the night.
Roberson getting out and quick in transition that time. Excellent at running the route in the open floor.
Here's Gasol. The shot misses. Adams, some nice D. Anthony kicks to George. Takes a three. That's in there. Anthony with the assist. George has got 5.
And defensively, this is a nightmare. He's already on a roll.
I love his will, his take charge attitude, the aggressiveness, all of that showing up here in the first.
Now here's Mills. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game. Aldridge with a screen on Anthony. Aldridge a screen. Anderson. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Anderson's got his first basket.
Effective and fundamental basketball there. That's Aldridge. Sets the solid screen to free up his teammate.
Anthony kicks to George. Back to Anthony. The kick out to Westbrook. Off target with his three. Last outing for San Antonio is a loss to the Timberwolves in Minnesota.
Just didn't like the energy level in that one, and that offensive execution also was lacking.
Well, they made a few shots, Reg, but just wildly inconsistent.
And that one's good. Green.
You're trying to space the floor. Green's the guy you want out there. The defense is forced to respect him from range.
Back to Robertson. Here's George. The feed to Anthony. Battles through traffic and lays it in.
And his versatility on offense is so spectacular. He always finds ways to help put points up on the board.
For San Antonio, they've gotten 3 of 8 shots to fall for them here in the first quarter. Aldridge is screened. Outside, Green. Pass to Aldridge. There's 21 seconds left to play in the first, and it goes down 2 points.
A super high percentage shot from Aldridge there. Layups work.
Kicks to Robertson. Right side, Westbrook. Adams dishes to George. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. They get Pau Gasol. The Thunder shooting their first free throw. First trip to the line in this one. And both free throws good for Paul George.
Encouraging sign there to see him knock down the free throw.
Gay outside from downtown. And again, it's San Antonio with a three.
Gotta admire the fast release of Gay. Once he has the ball in his hands, he's looking to shoot.
At the end of one, a closely contested game so far. Spurs lead by 2. Live from the AT&T Center in San Antonio, you're watching 2K Sports. And the San Antonio Spurs have really popularized that unselfish offensive style of play. Manu Ginobili talked about their Spurs approach.
Attack and find the open teammate, not try to solve problems by ourselves. It's something that we've never done, and every time we did it, it's not us.
There's a lot to be said for knowing, Greg, who you are and what your game plan is, and there may be no other team that gets that better than the San Antonio Spurs.
And Kevin, it helps to have that core of Manu and Tony there as the foundation and coaches on the floor for each new wave of players that have come through this Spurs organization.
Well, it's been a tight one so far as we get the second quarter going back here. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Spurs?
I mean, you saw it. That barrage of threes has them grooving here after one.
Well, they found a little bit of space out there on the perimeter, and they have a shared confidence right now. That tends to breed some success for this team.
So for Oklahoma City right now, on the wings, Abrines and George. Grant is out there with Patrick Patterson. Then it's Felton in at the point guard. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Kevin, the Spurs' Greg Popovich talked about developing players. He said, our method is usually tough love. I don't think coddling works, and beating them to death mentally doesn't work either. You give them a clear picture of what's demanded, show care, understand what makes them tick. If that doesn't get through, you get rid of them. Kevin?
And the military background of Popovich plays a part in this way of thinking, David. It's why the Spurs have been so successful for so many years. Greg, the one thing about Patrick Patterson out of Kentucky, he is a smart basketball player.
Yeah, he's not the best rebounder or shot blocker, but the advanced stats love him. And he gets the job done at both ends of the floor.
Now here's Murray. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. And stolen by Felton. Grant the pass to George. Abrines kicks to George. Laverne grabs the miss. San Antonio's gone 3 of 3 from three-point land here tonight. Ginobili gets a wide-open look. Again, the miss by the Spurs. The pass to Grant over Gay. Some nice passing by Oklahoma City here. Felton kicks to Grant. And George, here we go. Basket counts. George has got 9.
And I just love the aggressiveness from George, just slicing apart the defense with that terrific ability to penetrate.
Now here's Ginobili. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. They set the pick down low. And the bucket counts. 3-point chance here.
Very well executed pick to give him all kinds of space to get that one off.
And a new group getting ready for Oklahoma City. Adams, he's checked in for Patterson. Carmelo Anthony comes in for Jeremy Grant. Andre Robertson, he's checked in for George. And Russell Westbrook is subbed in for Raymond Felton. Here's Abrines. Fires the three. It's hauled in by Gay.
This OKC team is one of the best in the league when it comes to getting themselves to the free throw line. And a lot of that comes with the sheer force of Russell Westbrook, who draws a ton of fouls. But there's a few other crafty players who can get to work on the inside and find their way to the free throw line.
Now here's Westbrook, following the miss by Carmelo Anthony. Back to Westbrook, takes a three. The rebound by the Spurs. Anderson's got three rebounds so far in the game. There's the dish to Murray. He kicks it to Aldridge. Over Anthony. Not enough on that one as it misses. The Thunder, a strong team at getting points off free throws, Brent. It helps having Cantor, who's also good at drawing fouls.
Well, we see how much a team can have success just stealing easy points from the free throw line. So most teams that are near the top in terms of finding free throw attempts per game find their way into postseason play. The Thunder have set that trend. Westbrook's aggressiveness, Cantor on the inside, and Adams playing aggressive around the rim. That's a gorgeous assist. Outstanding at finding his guys in the spots where they want the basketball. Yeah, we're chipping some orange paint off the rim here, guys. He must be more patient on offense and trying to find ways to penetrate inside and get closer to the rim.
12 seconds left here in the second. And finished off by Westbrook.
That's a Westbrook mindset right there. I'm going through you. He doesn't allow his focus to be shaken, even when the defense gets a little bit nasty.
Tie game in San Antonio. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Carmelo, first half in the books. What do you need to focus on in the second half to get this win?
Well, just communication and trusting one another. When somebody get beat, the next guy got his back, and we're just trying to get up and down, get going somewhere, somehow. For the most part, we did pretty good. A couple of adjustments on the defensive end. Make some shots, and we'll be fine.
Well, thanks for your time, Carmelo. We'll see you in the second half. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Time to check out the first half of action. A pretty close game for the Spurs throughout the first quarter. They were unable to ever build a big lead in the first period, with 3 points being their largest cushion. They couldn't hold on to the slim lead they had at the start of the second quarter and headed into the locker room with the game all knotted up. And Shaq, what are your thoughts on how San Antonio played?
Well, I didn't even know who some of these guys were, but their bench came up with some big shots, gave the team a lift offensively. It's always possible those guys will see more minutes in the second half, but at the same time, if you're a starter, you're a starter for a reason. We shall see, Ernie.
And over to Kenny, your thoughts on the Thunder.
Well, it's always a little bit of a challenge playing on the road, but they came in mentally prepared and physically prepared. The energy in the arena was fierce, but they didn't cave in.
And that is just about going to wrap it up as the second half is moments away.
The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams battling hard through the first half. Paul George really making a difference here.
And I love the game plan in that first.
Over the past couple years, Brent, we've seen coaches like Steve Kerr and Brad Stevens take more of an even-tempered approach. Could that become a coaching trend going forward?
Well, I like that both Steve and Brad have some very good players. That would keep me calm too, Kevin.
Yes, it would. You begin right there, right?
Yeah, I think we're seeing a shift in what it is that the generation of the younger players has grown up with. And coaches that have the ability to communicate always, Kevin, are going to come out on top. They get their message through, they keep their team positive, and they keep their environment pointed in the direction.
Oh!
Yes, sir. That's ferocious Melo with some hang time and just crushes the jam.
That was a great angle we just saw, courtesy of Under Armour. Another Unleash Chaos moment. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, guys, Kawhi Leonard has become a go-to scorer, but his focus still starts at the defensive end. He said, my mindset is the same every game. Whoever I'm playing against, I go in and try to stop the best scorer and then try to get myself going in the offensive end. Kevin?
And David, that's what you get with Kawhi. Mr. Consistency, one of the best two-way players in the game. Steven Adams, he's checked in for Oklahoma City.
Just get a feeling like Melo has brought some extra energy to this one. This guy eats, drinks, and breathes basketball, but he's at it here tonight.
Gasol's in the post. Adams on him. Lock at six. Aldridge a screen. Here's Anderson. And Adams sends it back.
Well, Adams quick off his feet there with that size and length. Tough to shoot over.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Back to George. He dishes it to Anthony. Here's Roberson. But they recover it. A three-pointer, no good. Over in the corner, Green. And again, it's San Antonio with a three.
And this is what it's all about, guys. The competitive spirit, the energy that we're seeing. This one's got the feeling like it's going to go down to the wire.
And if it does, as evenly as these two teams have played here, it's anyone's guess who's going to come out on top.
Mills with it. Now Anthony defending. Fires from deep. Mills can't hit.
Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
And the Spurs, Greg, one of the best defensive teams in the league for two seasons running.
And it's really all about execution. I mean, they seem to just move in concert and stay connected. No silly fouls. And with their length, nothing easy inside.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game.
And he's probably looking at some matchups on the floor he'd like to take advantage of.
I'm interested in what he's seeing and then what kind of play they run coming out of this timeout.
So San Antonio goes with a fresh five on the floor. And Laverne kicks to Bertans. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. There's Ginobili. Finds himself wide open and drills it. And the Spurs lead by one.
Just a great catch and shoot player. Ginobili is so good at losing the defender and carving out just enough space to get off a clean shot.
Third quarter here, and 3 minutes have come off the clock. Now, here's Felton. He's covered closely. Bertans kicks to Laverne. Manu Ginobili on the wing. Offline with his three. Thunder have gone 3 of 4 so far in the third quarter from the field. Pretty good start to the half. Johnson, the pass to Abrines. Shot clock reset for Oklahoma City. Another shot. There's the foul. It's on Patrick Patterson. That'll be his second foul of the game.
And that's just all about positioning. He gets boxed out, can't fight around it, and gets the over-the-back call.
Guys get excited about making something happen, but that was just a loss of composure right there. You can't go through the guy.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Thunder. This game coming on the heels of their win against Chicago.
You know what, though? Not only did they get to the free throw line a lot, but they converted at a high clip.
Oh, they did. You can get to the line all you want, but it doesn't really mean much if you can't hit your free throws. And they were rock solid at the stripe.
And the Thunder going with a whole new group out there. Gay with no one around. Once again off the mark by San Antonio. And George, here we go. Some solid defense from Gay. We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. Spurs out in front. They're up by one. Live from the AT&T Center in San Antonio, you're watching 2K Sports. Now let's hear what head coach Billy Donovan was reviewing with his team in the huddle.
We got to now start to anchor down defensively right now. Trust each other and trust the loads. It's not just one-on-one.
And thanks for joining us again as the fourth quarter of play is set to get rolling. It's been a close battle to this point. Oklahoma City trailing. So for Oklahoma City right now, Westbrook and Robertson are the backcourt pair. Anthony out there with Paul George. And it's Adams in at the center, locking down the middle. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Well, Steven Adams can have an impact on the game, certainly defensively, certainly with the screen setting. But how about the character of the center of this basketball team? One of the most quotable players in the league, and he'll never hold back from speaking his mind in an interview. Gotta love his disposition.
And DeJounte Murray gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul.
Yeah, way to get there first and be willing to absorb the contact.
George dishes to Westbrook. Pass to Adams. Westbrook kicks to Roberson. To the paint. Deflects the pass. Outside Westbrook. Off target from three-point range. And with Adams being so likable and quotable, a lot of it has to do with his incredible wit.
Well, I'm looking forward to the Steven Adams talk show once his career is finished. Or maybe not. Maybe before his career is finished. But when you're the younger sibling, you usually come up with a very refined sense of humor.
Right, right. Like you, Brent. San Antonio trailing here. Fourth quarter just getting started. 1 minute in the books. There's a screen. Gay outside. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in. Gay's got it all tied up now for San Antonio. It's Anthony with the drive. And Adams now top of the key. Outside for George. Adams against Gay. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
Well, love the aggressive play here from Adams. He gets the shot he wants, and now another opportunity to challenge himself at the free throw line.
So both teams changing it up here.
They're ahead, but if they don't get a stop here, that free throw could prove critical. And so far, this has got that feel of a game that could be back and forth all the way.
I wouldn't be surprised in the least. Both teams really struggling to maintain any sort of momentum.
Here's Eustace. Here's Adams. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass. Adams has got 4 points this quarter.
Well, you have to put at least one body on Adams, maybe two. With his size and relentlessness, he'll light you up on the offensive glass.
And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Gasol. So it's the Thunder now. It's a one-point game. Adams, right side. Passes it to Abrines. Here's the screen. For three, Felton. The shot misses. And the Spurs going the other way now. Now here's Mills. He's covered by Felton. Mills passes to Gasol. Dishes to Green. Aldridge inside. Patterson defending. Aldridge misses.
And you got to give him credit there. Great effort to contest that shot.
Well, I love the fact that they put the security system on their house, protecting the paint there.
Here's Anderson. Good, and the assist goes to Gasol.
Gotta love the overall court awareness. Gasol always knows when there's a wide-open teammate ready to shoot and sometimes makes a dribble to set defenders up before delivering.
Outside for Felton. Looking for Adams. He gets it there. And out of bounds as San Antonio gains possession.
And what a time to get sloppy. A close game like this, you cannot be getting loose with the ball.
And a new group getting ready for Oklahoma City. Anthony's checked in for Patterson. Paul George comes in for Eustace. Andre Robertson, he's checked in for Alex Abrines. And Russell Westbrook subbed in for Raymond Felton. Here's Aldridge. It's hauled in by Adams. Anthony kicks to Westbrook. And again, Oklahoma City, no good. we can probably expect to see him slow it down now.
Yeah, I think you want to milk your possession.
2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Mills dishes to Anderson. Got a piece of it. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Good looking screen by Gasol. Shot off the pick. Up again. It falls.
Like he hasn't made clutch shots before. Kevin, wow. Pau Gasol with a confident shot with the game being tight.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They're behind by 3. Just 2 seconds left in the fourth. Guys, your thoughts?
And they need a 3 to tie. But look, they've got enough time here to find a good look. They can run a play off the inbounds, make sure they get it in the hands of their best shooter.
And now a moment to take a look at our Jordan player of the game.
And in terms of his shooting, this has been one of the more accurate performances you'll ever see. I mean, he's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good looks for himself. But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. That has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
From deep, George. Oh, he had a chance there to send it to overtime, but they come up empty-handed. And so it's San Antonio who's straight by with the win. What a show they put out here at home tonight.
I mean, these are those games that feel so great to win, and really, it's like a knife in the gut to lose. You gotta love being on edge of your seat and just wondering what's gonna happen. How is this thing gonna play out?
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Danny, a strong defensive effort both individually and team. Now, how comfortable are you at that end of the floor now, knowing that you can make things tough on the opposition?
Well, we want to make them take tough shots. We're not comfortable at any point defensively, but we got to continue to be active and be aggressive and get our hands on loose balls.
It's been the mark of the Spurs for a long time, Danny. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. We'll see you next time.